everyone. So today I want to talk to you about this man, Jeff Berwick. He is a liberty activist, a conspiracy kook, and an investment advisor who's done little more than assist nearly everybody who's worked with them to lose millions of dollars in his investment schemes. But I'm sure one of these days it's going to work out, right? After his failed rap career, Jeff went on to make it big in the 90s during the internet bubble and has been riding on that success to give terrible advice, like losing all of your money in a land scheme in Chile called Galt's Gulch. Though we don't really know for sure who was the guilty party in Galt's Gulch, since everybody seems to be pointing the fingers at each other, I thought this might shed some new light into Jeff Berwick and how he does business. QTDVImmigration.com, a service where you can buy a passport from another country and see the world. Now, I can't say that this service is one of these scams we've been hearing about. I would never say anything to that effect. However, there have been other services like this, which, let's just say, aren't exactly ran by the Rotary Club. So let's talk about another one, as Hans Hermann Hoppe would say, so to speak. Now, the internet is brimming with warnings about passport scams, and in fact, there was a particularly interesting post at LouRockwell.com talking about some unnamed passport scams. Now, not only are these illegal, but they're bogus, meaning that even if you do, and myself included, do not care about the state's rules, you are not going to get the service you paid for. It's fraud. How it works like this is you give upwards of $30,000 to a company. We'll just call it, I don't know, Anarchy and Acapulco Passport Scam.biz, or something like that. Then they somehow magically pass the government's rules about proof of permanent residency for obtaining a passport. That is, waiting at least 5 years before applying for citizenship. You must also be able to speak Spanish fluently and demonstrate substantial integration into the Mexican culture. Then you get a passport that allows travel visa-free in over 160 countries. How is that magic done, you ask? Well, that's simple. It's done with bribes. So what's the problem? Well, when a new administration comes into the government, or new officials come into the government, they usually start weeding out the corrupted officials of the previous administration. And revoking bogus passports are going to be happening. It's happened before. If you're in the U.S. and the state finds out that you have a passport that is fraudulent, you will be imprisoned under the Foreign Corrupt Practices Act. And many other countries have very identical laws, and you will be physically removed. However, with this theoretical company we're still calling Anarchy and Acapulco Passport Scam.biz, that's not even the worst part of it. The worst part is that these magically begotten passports you ordered never fucking came, because the guy who was supposed to be getting that passport went to jail, and the other guy who was supposed to help getting the passport has been squandering all of his money on booze to deal with the problem. Terrible. So now that we've talked about this totally unrelated company, let's talk about Berwick. A new video surfaced on the Galt's Gulch Chile channel showing Berwick talking on Skype about why his company has been having problems obtaining the passports he was paid for, and how he just bribes government officials in order to get said passports, and some people in his firm have been getting arrested, and he's washing away his problems with alcohol. Surely that's just coincidental. After the story broke on ChristopherCantwell.com, it has also been making the rounds in other libertarian circles as well. Now, how do you think Jeff Berwick has been handling this PR flop? Intelligently, I assume. He's a very successful businessman, right? Surely he's taking the advice of a very knowledgeable PR representative to clean up this mess. Surely he'll talk about how he was taken out of context by a disgruntled ex-associate, or perhaps it was some sort of acting for a comedy skit. Oh, dear God. He's going with the tinfoil hat defense. Okay, so I don't know exactly what to say about this. I mean, Cantwell and LouRockwell.com are CIA plants who are breaking into your house and accusing your wife of framing some guy for rape? Seems legit. Now, I'm just going to go out on a limb here and say, don't give this guy your money anymore. Might be a bad idea. And you might just want to sit on the fence on this one until it washes over. Even if he wants you to do a podcast, I just... just wait it out. I mean, it might all be false and Berwick might be the center of some global New World Order conspiracy, but might be for the best not to buy anything he's selling. Just my opinion. Worms.